Welcome to all. In this session, we'll discuss a C programming laboratory program, program number 7. This program is to implement using functions to check whether the given number is prime and display appropriate messages. And he suggested no built-in math functions. Now, we have to check a integer whether it is prime or not, and if it is prime we have to display number is prime, and if it is not prime we have to display number is not prime. And this implementation is using C functions, so very interesting and very important use of user defined functions in this program. Normally we used to have function main, which is a user defined function, only one user defined function in every C program, but where in this case we are using one more to check whether given number is prime. And he mentioned built-in function math is not supposed to use, because to limit the denominator values where in the process of dividing to check given number is prime or not is possible to restrict by upper limit. So if you say, for example, I want to check whether number 9 is prime or not, it is possible to divide that 9 from 2 and check its remainder is there or not. Like this we have to proceed further. So up to where? So 9 divided by 2, 9 divided by 3, 9 divided by 4, 9 divided by 5. Up to where we have to proceed is that it is square root of 9 at the denominator. Till square root of 9 at the denominator we can proceed. So such approach is not possible to use in this program. That is what mean by no built-in math function. Let us check what is a prime number. All of us mathematically know that a prime number has only two factors. That is 1 and the number itself. Let us consider some numbers. We'll go for first 2. We know that 2 is a prime number. It is because 2 is possible to obtain by 1 and 2 product. So that means by multiplying 1 and 2, it is possible to obtain 2. So that is 1 into 2 is nothing but 2. So no other factors than 1 and 2, it is impossible to obtain 2. That's why prime number 2 is a prime number. Let us go for number 11. So number 11 is a prime number because where this number is also having 1 and 11. So when I multiply 1 by 11, it is possible to obtain 11. And no other two numbers or no other number along with this 1 and 11, impossible to obtain answer 11 in the multiplication. Or other way, if I say that 11 is not possible to divide by any other number than 1 and 11. Similarly here in this case, 2 is not possible to divide by any other number than 1 and itself. So almost all prime numbers are possible to divide by itself and 1 only. That's why they are having only two factors. Let us consider number 15. Number 15 is not a prime number. It is because number 15 is possible to obtain by multiplying by 1. So it is 15. And if we try to have 15 in any other fashion, yes, there are numbers. 3 if I multiply with 5. It is possible to obtain again 15. So now 1 into 15 or 3 into 5, it is possible to obtain 15. So altogether there are 4 factors for this 15. So when a number is having more than 2 factor is considered as not prime. Now based upon this strategy or based upon this information, if we try to generate prime numbers up to 50, these are the prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7 till 47. Now if you consider a number from here, it is 37, and if you try to divide it by any other number than 1 and itself, it is impossible to divide it with 0 remainder. So now, if I divide this by 1, yes, it is divisible. If I divide this 37 by itself, it is divisible. In both cases, the remainder is 0. In any other division than this 1 and 37, it is not giving remainder 0 at all. Like that, if you check any other number from 2 to 47 in this range, all are prime number and all are divisible by itself and 1 only. So they are having two factors. Now if I consider 1 out of this range, that is 2, is only even prime number available. So now this is the only one, and all other prime numbers are odd prime numbers. But 2 is an exception where in case of prime numbers, it is a even prime number. Now watch out, 1 is not a prime number. Why 1 is not a prime number? It is having only one factor. Now to obtain 1, we have to write like this, that is 1 multiplied by itself. 1 into 1 is nothing but 1. So altogether, I am using digit 1 to obtain its factor, its product. And 1 into 1 means multiplying 1 by itself is nothing but 1, where if I consider factor, it is having only one factor. That's why 1 is not a prime number. So we consider generally the definition of prime number in this fashion. A prime number is a number that is divisible by itself and 1. That means in these two situations, it will produce the remainder 0. In all other cases, it will give you non-zero remainder. Other way of defining same, the prime number is a natural number which is greater than 1, and that cannot be formed by multiplying two smaller natural number. So as we know that digit 1 or number 1 is also a prime number, but is also a natural number, but it is not prime number. As I mentioned, it is having only one factor, that's why it is not a prime number. And any natural number which is bigger than 1, if it is not able to form, then we say it is a prime number. For example, consider 5. 5 is possible to write in two different fashion, 1 into 5 or 5 into 1. Now in both this writing or both this multiplication, we involved 5. So we know that the definition says that by multiplying two smaller natural number. Now 5 is a number smaller than that we have to consider into account for obtaining result 5. But 5 into 1 is nothing but now number that 5 itself is involved, that's why it is a prime number. Now a number greater than 1 that can be formed by multiplying two smaller natural number is called composite number. That means if I say 2 is a prime number, 3 is a prime number, how about 4? 4 is not a prime number. How about 5? Prime number. How about 6? 6 is not a prime number. Why 6 is not a prime number? It is a composite number. How you can say that it is a composite number? Because the product of this product 6 is possible to obtain by other two numbers which are bigger than 1 and smaller than 6. Which are those? It is 2 into 3 or 3 into 2. So just see this 2 and 3, both are bigger than 1 and both are smaller than 6. That's what the definition say, where in the case 2 smaller natural number is called a composite number. Now 6 is possible to obtain by 2 into 3 and 3 into 2. So both these 3 and 2 are smaller than 6 and they are bigger than 1. That's why this is 6 is a composite number. Let us consider an example where in this example we have to check number 23 whether it is prime or not. Practically we know that it is a prime number. But logically, how we have to do verification? So in the process, we have to divide this 23 by 2 23 by 2, that means 2 to 11. So we have to do division of 23 by 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So like this, we have to do division 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times we have to divide. So how this 10 times are decided? We have to start it from 2, and whatever that number, divide it by 2. When you divide 23 by 2, result we know that it is 11.5. But where we are talking about integer and integer at numerator and denominator, so it is integer by integer. Result is integer, that is 11. So 2 to 11, you can observe 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11 at the denominator. Keeping 23 at the numerator, we have to proceed for the division. When dividing, we have to check remainder of this division. We are not interested in the quotient of this division. We have to check remainder of this division to ensure whether 23 is prime or not. If remainder is 0 for any one of above division, that means in case 23 by 2, if you check remainder, if it is 0, then no need to proceed further to dividing 23 by 3, 23 by 4, 23 by 5. There itself we can declare that it is prime, it is not a prime. And in case a remainder is other than 0, we say it is a prime. In all cases we have to check. Remember, the division must be verified against to prove that it is not prime. In any one of the division, if you get a remainder 0, then we can declare that that number is not a prime. But to declare a number is not prime, declare a number is prime, we have to do division of that number from all possible divisions we have to do. So at the end, in any one of those division, if you get 0, we say it is prime. No, it is not prime. In case none of those division produces the result remainder non-zero, then we say it is a prime number. And just see here in the above division, 23 divided by 2, so where 2, 11 times 22 and remainder is 1. 3, 7, so it is 21, remainder is 2. 4, 5, so 20, remainder is 3. 5, 4, so remainder is 3. 6, 3, so 18, so remainder is 5. 7, 3 is 21, remainder is 2. 8, 2 is 16, remainder is 7. 9, 2 is 18, remainder is 5. 10, 2 is 20, so remainder is 3. So 11, 2 is 22, so remainder is 1. You can look at all these division, where all these division produces a remainder which is other than 0. That's why we can say 23 is prime. Now here is the algorithm to check prime number. So take a number, read a number, then check whether that number is less than 1. It is because you know that the prime numbers begins from greater than 1, because 1 is not a prime number, since because it is having a single factor. So other than number which is greater than 1, so that means prime number starts from 2 till the given value. So in case if you produce any value less than or equal to 1, we treat it as it is not a prime number. Then soon we will go to the last step, it is step 5, to end the algorithm. In case if number is bigger than 1, then we have to proceed dividing that number from 2 till half of its value. So now if I say 25, if number is given number is 25, then first we have to divide it by 2, then we have to divide it by half of 25. Half of 25 means 25 by 2 is nothing but 12.5, but 25 by 2 is nothing but integer by integer, result is 12. So if 2 is less than equal to 12, we have to check and we have to proceed for the verification whether the given number is prime or not. So we are in the process, we are doing division and verifying the remainder of that division. So number divided by 2, whether that remainder is 0. In case if I say 25, 25 divided by 2, is that remainder is 0? No, it is 1. When it is 1, if yes, we have to say that it is not prime and go to step 5. Let us consider one more where in the process. If it is 23, so 23 is divided by 2, so where we get remainder. And then since it is no, so remainder is this, remainder is not equal to 0, because you know that 23 divided by 2 is nothing but remainder is 1. So this 1 is not equal to 0. That's why the condition is false and it will go to step 4 again to verify the condition further. Increasing value of I by 1. Initially it was 2, then it becomes 3. 3 is divided by 3 is whether less than number. Given number is what? 23. 23 divided by 2 is nothing but 12. So 3, whether it is less than 12, yes, yes means again do the process. And like this, it will repeat and till the end, when this condition is false, it will come out and it will say that the number is prime. So altogether, in the process of verifying the remainder of a division, if you produce result non-zero, that is if remainder is non-zero, we can say the number is prime. If remainder is 0, we can declare that it is not a prime. Here is flowchart. So take a number. Now here I have a trace for this. So you can observe a trace of this. So in this trace, you can see some values. Initially, num equal to 1. So when I read num equal to 1, so I'm checking the condition soon after that, whether 1 is less than equal to 1. Is that 1 is less than equal to 1? Is that 1 is less than equal to 1? It is not less than, but it is equal to 1. So condition is true. If condition is true, where it will go? It will go to display number is not prime. So number is not. Let us take one more number. It is 9. So where in this case? I'll read number 9. So now next, 9 is less than equal to 1. Here it is 9. 9 is less than equal to 1. Is that 9 is less than equal to 1? No. If it is true, it will say that it is not prime. But at present, 9 is not possible to tell at this stage it is not prime. So we have to proceed further. Why? Because we have to divide that by 2, then 3, then 4 and 5. So this process or 3, then 4. So like that we have to divide and we have to confirm. So it will come to this point. Now where in this case I equal to 2. So initially I have to divide that 9 by 2. When I divide 9 by 2, before that I have to check whether that I value 2, whether it is less than equal to num by 2. So what is that 2? Num by 2. Num by 2 is nothing but 9 by 2. 9 by 2 is nothing but 4.5 means we have to round it to integers. So it is integer division. So it is 5. It is 4. So 2 is less than equal to 4. Condition is true. That means this condition is true. When this condition is true, we have to verify one more condition. What condition it is? 9% 2. So where this process to verify the remainder. So 9% 2, that means it is modulus operation, where 9% 2 is nothing but so you will get remainder of that 9% division 2. It is actually where in the process 1. So 1 is equal to 0. False. So 1 is not equal to 0. That's why it's false. So it will go out. Go and repeat that increasing value of I by 1. So here in this case, I value E, earlier it was 2. Now we have to increase it. We have to increase it. And we have to now value of I is nothing but 2 plus 1, it is 3. So while going back, the I incremented by 1 and it will become now 3. Next, we have to verify that condition here. It is whether 3 is less than num, less than or equal to num by 2, whether it is less than or equal to num by 2. So if so, we have to consider this. So now we are in the process. We have value, it is 3. 3 is less than or equal to 9 by 2, that is 4. So 9 by 2, which is 4. So this condition is true. When this is true, again we have to verify this modulus operation result, where it is 9 percentage 3. So 9 percentage 3 means 9 divided by 3. What remainder we are getting? Remainder we are getting 0. So 0 is equal to 0. Yes, this is giving 0. 9 by 3, that is 9 percentage 3, result is 0. 0 is equal to 0. Yes. Yes means condition is true. Soon when condition is true, it will go outside and it will print that number is not prime. Now here one more you can observe. It is nothing but this. Now here in everywhere, I missed out the equal sign in the process, and I am adding it now. So now you can see all those. Now let us consider num11. When num11, we read from the keyboard. We are verifying 11 is less than 1. No means it will come here. Now we have to do division of that 11. 11 percentage 2 we have to do. And where in the process we are not getting. 11 by 2 is nothing but remainder 1. 1 is equal to 0. This is 1. This is 0. Is that it is? No. No means it will go out. Now here again it will increase value of I by 1 more. So what is that? It is 3. 3 num by 2 is again it is 11 by 2. 11 by 2 is nothing but 5. And 3 is less than 5. Condition is true. When condition is true, it will divide that 11 by 3 for remainder. So 11 by 3 means 3 is on 9. So 2 remainder. 2 equal to 0? No. 2 is not equal to 0, then increase again I value by 1 more. So it becomes now 4, I becomes 4. And this 4 is less than equal to num by 2. So that is 11 by 2, it is 5. So 4 is less than 5, condition is true. When it is true, now 11 percentage 4 we have to do. So 11 percentage 4 means 4 2s are 8, remainder is 3. And 3 is equal to 0? No. That's why condition is false. When this condition is false, again it will go back, increasing value of I by 1 more. So now I becomes 5. Now 5 is verified against num by 2. So that is 5 is less than 5. If this condition is true, it will do 11 divided by 5 for remainder division. When 5 2s are, it is 10. So remainder becomes 1. 1 is equal to 0. Here it is 1. Here it is 0. Condition is false again. It will go back, increasing value of I by 1 more. So it becomes now 6. Now 6 is less than a num by 2. No, 6 is less than 5. Condition becomes false. So here itself the condition becomes false. When it is false, it will display number is prime. And it will go to the connector. Using connector, I connected it to the end. So you can see that in the last example, we are able to find number is prime. Now we'll look into the program. So here in the program we have same three traces, and in these traces we'll look into the result and we'll see how exactly it processes where in the computation. So now here the first line of the program is nothing but hash include stdio.h, and let me add first all these comparison with equal sign, and also I missed out in the other part also, so we can consider those also. So here also let me correct those first. Now so here it is equal, let me explain third example directly so that you can understand better, I believe. So we'll start from first line of this program. So program begins with hash include stdio.h. All of you know that stdio.h is a header file, where in this header file we have definitions for printf and scanf. Now here in this program you can observe the printf and scanf are there at function main. So this is the second page of that program. So inside function void main, this is a user defined function by default available in all program. Return type of that user defined function is void here, and you can observe open parenthesis here, close parenthesis here, all the statements which are there inside this written by us. That's why this is a user defined function. Now here in this user defined function we have printf, scanf, and again another printf here, again another printf here. So you can observe three printfs and one scanf. Because of these three printf and scanfs, one scanf, we are having this header file stdio.h, which will give definitions for those printf and scanf. So soon after giving definition for those two functions, printf and scanf, this preprocessor directive will be removed in the object code. Similarly, those printf and scanfs are replaced by several other lines from the definition of the definition std from the file stdio.h. stdio.h means it is standard input output header file. Now let me start explaining the other part. Now here to here, if you observe, this is entirely the user defined function. So this is return type of user defined function. It is integer, and is prime is nothing but name of this function, and what you enclose inside this parenthesis is nothing but a parameter. So num is a parameter, is of type integer. So this is the header of the user defined functions. More about this we'll see when I explain after this function main. Now C program execution starts from function main. We declared number is of type integer, because to check whether given number is prime or not, number must be integer. It is not possible to check a number if it is fraction. As I mentioned, prime numbers are those, they are bigger than 1 and they are possible to divide by itself and 1. So that is what a number which is bigger than 1 must be entered from the keyboard, and they must be always a positive number. So to make user friendliness, here is a printf statement. Here this printf statement will provide information to the user saying that take a number from the So this printf function tells the user to enter a non-zero number. Why? Because when it is a zero, it is not possible to consider while in the process. That's why we have to take a non-zero number. If it is zero, it is not possible to tell it is prime or neither prime or not, nor composite number. So it will display in the screen, enter a non-zero number. Then soon after that, you will find that the blinking cursor in the new line because of this backslash n. Scanf function, where we are reading value for this num. Num is of type integer, that's why we have control string here, percentage %d. And ampersand is to tell about that while declaring this num will have some reserved space there at the computer primary memory, and that primary memory address is indicated by this ampersand. So ampersand num means it is address where we reserved, or the where compiler reserved space for num. Now soon after that we are going for a if else statement. Now this if else statement here, if followed by a condition there inside this open and close parenthesis. Now if this condition is giving 1, if this condition gives 1, then it will execute this statement. And in case if this condition, what is there inside this, or if this expression results 0, it will execute this statement and then it will go outside. So now at present, inside this if statement, we have here is prime. What is this is prime? Is prime is nothing but the function what we defined in our program. So now you can see here at the beginning, we have a function here in our program. So this is nothing but is prime function. So is prime function we have to call. So this is nothing but function call. In user defined function, the user defined functions are written to do a particular task. So while executing a user defined function, we have to give some input for that. If there is a set of statement to do a particular task, now here in this program we are writing some statements to check whether given number is prime or not. So those statements are available there inside that isPrime function, which is a user defined function created here in this program. And that isPrime function is verified against to a number. Now we have to check whether a given number is prime or not. So what is that number you enter from the keyboard? That is nothing but num. So that number we have to pass. This is function name. So this function name then followed by this function parameter. Num is nothing but parameter. So all together what I highlighted here is nothing but a function call. In function call we'll have name of the function, it is isPrime. Then within parenthesis we'll have the variable name. That variable name what we are considered here is nothing but num. So num is given as parameter to call this function. When I call this, when I execute this statement, control jumps to the function definition. This is function call. From here the control jumps to function definition. So it will jump to the first line of this selection. So it will come to this line here. While coming from there, let us consider number 9. So if it is number 9, I have to consider. So let me go for number 9, where in the process 9 is copied from there to here. So isPrime, there also you know that number is defined as integer. So that 9 will come here. I am executing, I am tracing the value of num equal to 9 where in my process. So 9 is here now. So internally now this function begins from here and it ends here. Now in the process you know that we have to check whether number 9 is prime or not. So in that concern we have to consider a loop, because we have to divide 9 by 2, then 9 by 3, then 9 by 4. That's why we have to consider I to have value from 2 to 4. So you know that initially we have to divide 9 by 2, then we have to divide 9 by 3. Okay, by that time we are able to say whether it is prime or not. So half of its value, 9's half is nothing but 4.5. So where in the process it is nothing but 4. So to keep track of that denominator, we have this I here declared. It is again integer. So when a given number is integer, when we divide it by integer, it is possible to tell whether it is prime or not. Now here it is 9 we considered in the process. Now 9, is that equal to 0? No. Or if 9, is that equal to 1? So you can see that two conditions are verified. I'm checking whether 9 is equal to 0, or I'm checking whether 9 is equal to 1. So here 9 is not equal to 0 and 9 is not equal to 1. Both conditions are false. Altogether, this both conditions are false. When both conditions are false, it won't come into this part of the program at all. It will come to this line of the program now. So now what is that? You know that what we decided, a number whether it is less than 9, less than 1. Because number, if it is equal to 1 or less than 1, it is not possible to tell whether it is prime or not. Blindly we can say it is not a prime, because number which is equal to 1 and less than 1, it is treated as composite. It is non-prime. So now in case here in this case 9 is bigger than 1. 9 is bigger than 1. So we have to divide 9 by, now initially you can see that. So initialization is done. It is I equal to 2. When I equal to 2, we have to check whether 2 is less than num by 2. So 2 is less than num by 2. So what is that 2? 2 is nothing but I value. Num by 2 means 9 by 2. 9 by 2 is nothing but 4.5. 4.5 is nothing but 9 by 2 is 4. So 2 less than equal to 4. Condition is true. We have to verify this condition now. Since this condition is true, we have to jump to this part of the program. So this part of the program. When this condition is true, we have to do all the statement inside this. Right now this condition is true. I am executing these statements inside this. So what is that I am checking now? If number, that is 9, 9% I, that means 9 percentage 2, is that equal to 0? 9 percentage 2 is nothing but 1. So 1 is equal to 0. This result is 1. Is that equal to 0? So you can see that 9 percentage 2 is equal to 0. No, it is false. So when it is false, it will skip this part. Now because of this, control jumps from here, this line, to 4 again. While coming back, I value is incremented by 1. What is this? I plus plus means value of I is incremented by 1. You can observe here it is nothing but I equal to I plus 1. So it becomes 3 now. Now again we have to check this, whether 3 is less than equal to num by 2. So whether 3 is less than equal to num by 2. So 3 is less than equal to 4. Yes. Yes means we have to go for it is 9. This condition again true. When it is true, we have to execute all statements. When this is true, we have to execute all these statements. So because of this, what happens now? So it is 9 percentage I right now, it is 3. So 9 percentage I right now, 3. So 9 percentage I, 3 means it is 9 divided by 3 remainder equal to 0. So 0 is equal to 0. Yes, this condition is true. When this condition is true, it will execute this. What is this 0? Return 0. Return 0 means you called this function is prime from function main. So where you are returning value 0. So now this 0 will take this value 0. Because of this, the control jumps from here to where exactly the call is. So here, now it will put at this part of the program is 0. When this part of the program is 0. So 0 means we believe that condition is false. When condition is false, it will execute the 9 is not prime. Because 9 is divisible by 3, so it will end the program. This is how program execution takes place. Now we'll see how exactly it is executed wherein C compiler. Now right now I have that program in C compiler here. Now let me compile this program. When I compile this program, it will say that 339 lines are compiled. But practically you can count how many lines are there. Hardly you have here in this program. So total number of lines, it is 32. 31 lines are there. Now let me trace for value 9 only. So now before that, let me first run this program for value 9. When I run this program, I'll get result of this number 9, whether it is prime or not, in this fashion. So if you want to compile this program, you have to press Control F9. And followed by it is to run the program. Control F9 to compile and run the program. So now after running, it is asking me to enter a number to check whether it is prime or not. So I'll give value now 9. Then I'll press enter. Soon after that, it is taking me to this screen, blue screen. When I want to observe this result, then if I want to observe this result, I have to press Alt F5. You can see the 9 is prime, it is displayed there in the screen. So this is how it is possible to run the program. Now let me trace or let me debug this program. When you debug this program, the actual execution of C program, you will understand. That's why let me press F7 for same value 9. I want to check, or let me check the value 11, whether it is prime or not. So in the process of checking 11, it is prime or not, 11 divided by 2 I have to do, 11 divided by 3 I have to do, 11 divided by 4 I have to do, 11 divided by 5 I have to do, that's all. So these are in any of these division, if I get result remainder is non-zero, if I get remainder is 0, we say it is prime. If it is non-zero, we say it is non-prime. So let me debug this program for value 11. So I'll press now F7. When I press F7, C program execution starts from function main. That's why the control is highlighted there, void main. Then next, if I press F7, it's taking me to enter value for number. So I'm entering now 11. Then I pressed enter. Then again, I'm continuing with the F7. When I press F7, now it is calling the is prime. Now you can see the control how exactly jumps from function main to the function definition. You know that above this function main, you have the function definition. So now I'm not at press F7. Now you can observe Now I am pressing F7. When I press F7, control jumps in this fashion. So now it is transferred control to that function definition, and there it is copied a number value. It is 11. Now it is checking whether that number 11 equal to 0, 11 equal to 1. So no means it will skip this return and it will come to this for loop now. So when I press F7, it came to the for loop. Now it is dividing 11 by 2 and it is checking whether remainder is 0. No means it will go back. I press it once. Second time I press F7. Third time I press F7. So you know that it is 11 by 2, 11 by 3, 11 by 4. Now it is 11 by 5 is not possible, because so num divided by 2 is nothing but 5.5. Yeah, it is tried 5 also, sorry, 5. 11 by 5 also it will verify. Now you know that in all these cases the remainder is not equal to 0. That's why it came out from the loop and it is now returning 1. So where it is returning 1? It is returning 1 to the function main. You can see that now when I press F7, the control jumps into the place where I have, and it is here, it is 1 and it is true. So you know that 11 is prime. It is going to display now. If you check that result screen, pressing Alt F5, you can find 11 is prime. This is how the debugging and execution of C programming is done in Turbo C compiler. This is Turbo C compiler. Okay, now let me repeat. If you want to compile program, you have to press compile and run the program. You have to press Control F9. And further, if you want to enter value, press a value from the keyboard. I press 9. And when I press enter, it will take you to blue screen again. To see this result screen, you have to press Alt F5. You can see that 9 is not prime. Then again, if you press enter, it will take you to the blue screen. This is how execution is possible wherein a C program. And this is all about program number 7 of your lab, where we are checking a prime number using function, and this is not used any built-in function. So this is all about the program, and thanks for listening.